Hi, I'm Leah. You know, you can search the AutoChannel.com's new car buyer's guide to quickly and easily find specs, prices, multi-car comparison, and the latest news about every new passenger car and truck sold in North America. The AutoChannel.com, there's nothing else like it.
Jarno Trulli is one of the fastest and most experienced drivers in Formula One, and in his 12th year at the top, he's enjoying one of the best seasons of his career. As attention moves towards the Italian Grand Prix at Monza, Jarno's home race, it's time to look back at his motorsport journey. Jarno comes from eastern Italy, where the hills of Abruzzo sweep down to the Adriatic coast at Pescara. Jarno and his young family now live in Switzerland, but visits to Pescara are a welcome break in his busy schedule.
Well, it's nice to be back because I have my old friends, I got my family, I got nice memories. It's a nice place. It's good to be here, but I always spend a very short time. There is not much time for a Formula One driver to be spent in the same place.
Jarno's mother, Franca, has experienced every twist and turn of his career since he first raced a kart at the age of 8.
First and above all, it gives me a lot of satisfaction and emotion because he has managed to achieve his dream in life.
Jarno met his future wife at a charity football match when he was an up-and-coming Formula One racer with big ambitions.
I'm very proud of Jarno's work and his fulfillment. Regarding his lifestyle, on the one side it's very tiring and he's always on the go, but it gives him the chance to experience situations and emotions that he wouldn't be able to experience if he lived an easier life.
...2005 was a life-changing year for Jarno, with his first full season at Panasonic Toyota Racing and the birth of his first son, Enzo. Marco followed in 2006, and Jarno's enthusiasm has clearly rubbed off, even though he has no ambition for them to follow in his footsteps.
Well, I just hope that I will be fighting in another sport, like tennis, golf, or basketball, but... There is a lot of sacrifice, and more than anything else, they would always live in the father's shadow, which I don't think is so nice for children.
Yeah, I'll show you some of the trophies which I let in...
Jarno's parents have a selection of his trophies proudly on display. More than two decades of motorsport success.
And this is my first ever podium for Toyota. And I just hope it's the first of a long series because I'm looking forward to give Toyota the first victory.
For Jarno, each of these prizes brings back different memories. But what was his greatest success?
Well, certainly one was Monaco, the victory, but I must admit that the last podium with Toyota was great. A great moment for me, for the team, coming out from a few difficult seasons. And having a great, perfect weekend where not only me but also the team gave me such a good support that, you know, in the end it was a great result for everyone.
During his 12 years at the top, Jarno has shown a consistent passion for motorsport. And it's no wonder, his hometown is steeped in racing history. This is part of the Pescara track that last hosted a Grand Prix in 1957.
The background of this region in general in the motorsport is quite strong. The old days, talking about the 50s, we had one of the most important racing event of Formula One, where Enzo Ferrari, Villoresi and many other, Fangio I think as well, raced here.
When it comes to Jarno's own history, this is an important location. The karting circuit where his career began as a small child. The original threesome is reunited here. Jarno, his kart mechanic Dino La Cioppa, and his father. So how did it all begin?
You can say that he started going fast from the very beginning, despite the fact that he was lacking in preparation and didn't know much about the kart. In fact, almost nothing about it.
Every time I was coming back after a week of doing one certain training of basketball or football or whatever, I remember my family used to ask me, what do you like most, this and that, karting or football? And my answer was always the same for years. So in the end, it's not the fact that I have chosen to race in go-kart. The problem is I've been chosen because I born with that passion.
His father and I were friends, and he came here and started karting. He was passionate about it from the beginning, and he was always trying to do better. He needed to stop doing it because of school. But he kept coming back because he enjoyed it so much. He was like that.
Un ragazzo che gli piaceva proprio il kart, i motori.
25 years after his first kart race, and Jarno's talent is a key part of Panasonic Toyota Racing's success in 2008. But what of his character?
He is very determined and stubborn. He digs his heels in so he can be successful, whatever happens. And when it comes to his physical training, he's obsessed about it. If he has to train 2 hours a day, he trains 2 hours a day. He doesn't let other things distract him, like he doesn't go out at the expense of his physical training. For him, it's a duty, and he does what he has to do.
His qualities as a racer have been evident from the very start.
Jarno's strength, in my opinion, is his precise driving style. The laps he did at this track were always identical. From the beginning to the end, his line through the corners was always the same. This was his big strength when he was a kid.
Within the team, Jarno's race engineer probably knows him the best.
He's a very discreet person. Out of the car, he likes to be with his friends, long-time friends. He doesn't like the spotlight, and so this is quite good also to work with from this point of view.
The wine on the table bears Jarno's name and is a clue to one of his passions away from the world of F1 racing. His vineyards near Pescara.
Yeah, what sounds a little bit strange somehow is this split personality. I mean, how he can switch so quickly from a speed-based, frantic environment like Formula One and then go back home and take care of his vineyards, which is something which is goes really, really slow and requires patience and requires a lot of dedication, like Formula One, but in a very, very different way, in a very relaxed and patient way. This is quite amusing for me, how he can easily and successfully switch from one aspect of his life and the other one.
Jarno bought the Podere Castorani vineyard in 2000 and now produces around 600,000 bottles a year. Jarno is dedicated to excellence in everything he does. But what's the secret to his continuing success?
My secret is that I still have some target to achieve, and I don't want to give up on the target. And the passion for driving, the emotion I get, the challenge, it's something that I don't want anyone to take this away from me. I'm still extremely focused and committed on what I'm doing, so There is no point even on thinking about it. I just want to do it.
So speaks one of Formula One's most passionate drivers. And it's that passion which continues to inspire Panasonic Toyota Racing to new heights.
Looking for a new car or truck? TheAutoChannel.com has the most complete and up-to-date pricing, vehicle specifications, and reviews.